Right, okay, good afternoon, welcome to Church Farm. So first of all, I'm going to tell you a little bit about the weddings we do here. We do 9 each year, and if you look through this gateway on your right, you'll see why people want to spend their special day on the farm, because we've got such stunning views overlooking local farms in River Dee and North Wales. So we've got the choice of two marquee sites. We've got this lower site down here, where we put the teepees, and we've got the site on top of the hill on your left. That's where we put the traditional marquee structures. Birthday parties are also very popular here. That's because with a birthday party, you get a tractor ride around the farm where you can learn about the farm animals as well as meet them, feed them, go into the hen house, collect some eggs, and cuddle some guinea pigs. So one of the stars of the birthday parties lives in here. This is Daisy the pig. Sometimes during school visits and children's parties, we go inside the pen with Daisy, and if we're lucky enough, she'll come over to the children and say hello and enjoy a puddle and some stroking. Up this way, we've got the alpacas. A lot of people mistake my alpacas for llamas because the two animals can look very similar to each other. The best way to tell the difference between an alpaca and a llama is by looking at their ears. And that's because alpacas have got straight ears, llamas have got curved ears, which are shaped like bananas. So all you need to do is remember the rhyme, banana llama, look at their ears, and you should be able to work out the difference. Opposite the alpacas, we've got our two donkeys, Winston and Blossom. These two donkeys, like most, are able to live outside all year round, and that is because over winter they grow these incredibly thick coats, thick enough to keep their bodies nice and warm even on the coldest of days. And this time of year they start to molt, they shed their winter coat and leave the short summer coat underneath to stop them from overheating. Inside the pen on our right, we've got some of the youngest animals on the farm. We've got some lambs in there, they are 2.5 months old. They're very big for their age, that's because lambs grow at an incredibly fast rate because the ewe is producing really high energy milk for them to drink. It's important I keep a close eye on the lambs and the ewes this time of year. The ewes can lose a lot of weight over a short space of time because they're giving up so much energy creating, producing all this milk for the lambs. So if they require it, I'll give them any extra hard feed they need to make sure they stay in good condition. If you keep lots of farm animals together with lots of manure, we stack it nice and high and allow it to rot down over winter before we spread it over the fields and start planting our vegetables. So one of the main crops we now grow here are pumpkins. That's because over the October half term week we do a Halloween themed timetable on which there'll be fun puppet shows, obesity barrel train, all the animal talks will have a bit of a Halloween twist to them as well. But the most exciting thing on the town timetable is Pick Your Own Pumpkin, which involves a tractor ride up to the pumpkin patch where you'll have the opportunity to get up and cut a fruit fresh from the plant. As you can see, we also grow Christmas trees. We've got about 15,000 trees on the farm in total. This is one of our younger plantations. In the distance, on either side of the footpath, you can see more plantations over there. Every December, we put to sell about 1,000 trees. And in February, we plant twice as many as what we harvest. I managed to squeeze 2,000 trees into this field in the gaps. Most of the trees ended up in this bed we're just driving past now. There's quite a lot of empty spaces. You may just be able to make them out. They're only about 10 to 15 centimetres tall, hiding in between the weeds there. Those trees are planted in February, won't be harvested for another 10 years. And that's because the first 2 years after planting, we won't see any growth above the surface. That's because the trees are busy establishing their roots. From the third year onwards, I expect to see the trees to grow about 1 foot each year. So a typical 8-foot Christmas tree is usually about 10 years old. You can see we've got some older trees in front of us. Well, we use that part of the farm to host our events, such as the Easter egg hunt, where you get a tractor ride up to the forest, where you get off and take part in lots of fun games and activities. We also do the very popular Santa experience. Again, you get your tractor ride up to the forest, but this time when you get off, you'll be guided by one of the elves through all these different scenes, meeting many magical characters along the way. You can find out more about the events we do here at Church Farm by looking on our website, which is churchfarm.org.uk, or you can be kept up to speed by following us on our Facebook page, which is Church Farm Wirral. This lamp here, where we've just finished power harrowing, this is where we'll be planting the pumpkins. We've got 3,000 pumpkins to plant in this field, and hopefully we should be able to produce between 7,000 and 9,000 fruits. So over the next couple of days, I'll be up here with a machine called the mulcher, and that will lay black sheets of polythene for me before I start hand planting the plants through the ground cover, through the polythene. Now, there's two reasons why we grow pumpkins through sheets of polythene. First of all, it acts as a mulch. It will stop any weeds growing up and around the pumpkin plants, competing for light, nutrients and water. The other reason we grow pumpkins through black sheets of polythene is because it's black. When the sun shines on it, it heats up, warming the soil under the surface and the roots of the plant. That will trick the plant into thinking it's later on in the growing season than it is, and it tries to play catch up. It gets the plant growing a little bit quicker and a little bit earlier on as well. So just beyond this Christmas tree plantation, we've got one of our hay fields. In the summer, we allow the grass to grow long before we cut it down and leave it to dry out under the warmth of the sun. When the hay is nice and dry, we then fill it up and store it ready for the animals to eat over winter. Because as we all know, in the cold winter months, the grass doesn't grow, but the animals, they carry on eating, and eventually they'll run out of food in their paddocks. So when that happens, we need to make sure we've got plenty of hay stored ready to feed to them. Not only does this field provide the farm animals with food, it also provides them with water. At the very lowest point, we dug a borehole deep under the ground, creating a well. Church Farm's got a bedrock of sandstone, which means when it rains, the rainwater will filter through the soil, through the sandstone, and into the well, where it then runs through pipes underground to the farm animals. Countryside sometimes choose to keep these birds as pets, for the same reasons the Romans kept them, they'd use them as centurions. They'd use them as guard geese. That is because they are very territorial birds. If they were to spot an intruder, they would sound the alarm by honking. They'd also chase the intruder and cover them in lots of nasty bites and pecks. So just to let you know, folks, the next activity we have on today is the barrel train. That is at 3:45. It's all included as part of your admission ticket. It's one ride per person. And then later on after that, we'll be doing a little tour of the hen house. So I hope you've all enjoyed this tractor ride. I hope you all enjoy the rest of your visit here at Church Farm. I just ask if you could please stay sitting down until I come around and open the door. Thank you.